see what's going on Twitter today. Maybe I shouldn't. Starting the day off with Twitter usually doesn't end well. Yeah, whatever. Jim Acosta, 3 years ago today, Trump says there were, quote, very fine people on both sides in Charlottesville. Not again. Welcome back, everyone. Ever since Charlottesville, the media has continued to claim that during a press conference, Trump called neo-Nazis and white nationalists very fine people, despite there being plenty of video and transcript evidence to the contrary. This claim is so thoroughly debunked that I'm gonna use the video that Jim Acosta linked in his tweet to debunk the claim. We're gonna get right into this alternate reality fact check, but first, give me just a moment to tell you about this very special offer for my subscribers from this episode's sponsor, Orion Metal Exchange. How far will your US dollar go once we tally up all the debt accumulated in the fight against coronavirus? How will government-mandated business shutdowns affect the economy moving forward? My friends, uncertainty is the enemy investors and savers alike need to guard against. Now is the time to take action. Protect yourself, protect your financial future. Did you know that it took nearly 8 years for the markets to recover after the 2008 housing bubble crash? Yet, during the crash of 2000, do you really have 8 years to wait for a recovery? Guys. Bank of America, Goldman Sachs, and Citigroup all see gold soaring. Some experts are calling for gold to double in the next year. Orion Metal Exchange is Consumer Affairs' top-rated gold IRA dealer. Call today and request a free investment kit below. Mention Dronetek Politics and get a free 1 ounce silver coin for qualified retirement account holders. Must be over 40 to qualify. Call 866-915-5053 and get your free investment guide today. At Orion, you get more precious metals for your money every day. Look, Trump may not be the most eloquent, and he could have said this a lot better, but he most definitely did not call neo-Nazis and white nationalists fine people. I've done many videos on this topic going back several years, so it is mind-boggling to me that this lie persists. The only reason it does is because the media continues to not fact-check it and to use it as a weapon against Trump, proving that these fake fact-checks that they do are purely partisan in nature. Joe Biden has repeated this lie dozens of times on the campaign trail, only ever being called out by it by one journalist from Breitbart.
Mr. Vice President, are you aware that you were misquoting Donald Trump in Charlottesville? He never called neo-Nazis very fine people.
No, he called all those folks that walked out of that, they were neo-Nazis, shouting hate, their veins bulging.
But he said specifically that he was condemning them.
He did not.
You're changing history, you're changing culture, and you had people, and I'm not talking about the neo-Nazis and the white nationalists, because they should be condemned totally.
But he said specifically that he was condemning them.
He did not. I'm not talking about the neo-Nazis and the white nationalists, because they should be condemned totally. I'm sure in that group there were some bad ones. The following day it looked like they had some rough, bad people. Neo-Nazis, white nationalists, whatever you want to call them. I thought what took place was a horrible moment for our country. A horrible moment.
The media reported on the exchange, but get this, they framed it as Biden smacking down a right-wing propagandist. So I get on Twitter this morning, and it's apparently the anniversary of Charlottesville, and I see Jim Acosta again repeating this lie, knowing full well that he's lying. Why do I say that? Because it was Jim Acosta's question that led to this entire thing. And it wasn't even just Acosta, it was many others in the media, including some Democrats and Republicans, repeating this lie over and over until it becomes true. Now, I know I've heard about that tactic somewhere and somebody using it famously, but I can't quite remember. So I'm on Twitter and I'm doing a search for very fine people, and we're gonna see everybody who's perpetuating this lie. Here we have Ethan Wolf, who is the executive director of Jewish Unity, who says that 3 years ago, the president claimed there were very fine people on both sides, equivocating neo-Nazis with those who fought against hatred. But that's not at all what he did. It's like, did you even watch the press conference, or are you just repeating what you've heard over and over again? Then we have Doug Gordon here, who says that 3 years ago today, the president of the United States called neo-Nazis who killed innocent protesters very fine people. Then he posts this clip. Yet, listen, you go to 1 minute of this clip, and what's he say?
Mark from Rob, it's fine. You're changing history, you're changing culture, and you had people, and I'm not talking about the neo-Nazis and the white nationalists, because they should be condemned totally.
But you admit. So this guy posts this, and then he posts the clip That debunks his claim. It's like none of these people have actually watched any of this press conference. They just are told that he says it, and they just take it as a complete leap of faith. I mean, like, he can he not watch a minute and 12 long video? It's a minute long, and he apparently has not watched it. Here we have Fred Wellman, who's part of the Lincoln Project, which, if you don't know, is a bunch of Republicans who oppose Trump. And he says, 3 years ago today, I sat at home with my son-in-law serving with the Virginia National Guard to secure the Lee statue in Charlottesville. He didn't come home until almost midnight, and it's the longest day of my parenting life. Trump said they were very fine people. How about U.S. Senator John Hickenlooper, who says that Donald Trump defended white supremacists as very fine people? Again! I mean, we've watched the clip now. All of us have watched the clip dozens of times. What's he talking about? Then we have David Corn, who is a Democrat Party strategist, and also said that Biden smartly contrasts this day with the racist anti-Semitic Charlottesville march 3 years ago to the day and Trump's very fine people remark. Obviously misrepresenting what he said and just totally lying about it. And of course, no fact check on any of these posts, proving again that Twitter's fact checks are a complete joke. Then we have AJ Plus saying that it's been 3 years since the white supremacist rally in Charlottesville, and President Trump claiming that there were very fine people on both sides. Then we have the Biden-Harris War Room also saying that he called Nazis very fine people. Where's the fact checks? Even Jake Tapper on the same network as Jim Acosta admitted that Trump's words were being misrepresented.
Now, elsewhere in those remarks, the president did condemn neo-Nazis and white supremacists. So he's not saying that the neo-Nazis and white supremacists are very fine people.
In fact, Trump was very specific in explaining that he and other peoples that opposed the removal of those statues were doing so because the same logic could be used to remove Washington and Jefferson. And what's happening now? They're going after Washington and Jefferson.
And you had some very bad people in that group. But you also had people that were very fine people on both sides. You had people in that group, excuse me, I saw the same pictures as you did. You had people in that group that were there to protest the taking down of, to them, a very, very important statue and the renaming of a park from Robert E. Lee to another name.
Well,
no, George Washington was a slave owner. Was George Washington a slave owner? So will George Washington now lose his status? Are we going to take down statues to George Washington? How about Thomas Jefferson? What do you think of Thomas Jefferson? You like him? Okay, good. Are we going to take down the statue? Because he was a major slave owner. Now are we going to take down his statue? So you know what? It's fine. You're changing history. You're changing culture.
I want you to just clarify for our viewers briefly the distinction to be made between slave-owning presidents and founding fathers and slave owners who fought to keep that peculiar institution intact.
Recent press conference and multiple times on Twitter, President Trump has drawn comparisons between Confederate General Robert E. Lee and President George Washington. So here to defend himself is President George Washington.
Overnight, a group of people tore down the George Washington statue in Northeast Portland. This was near Northeast 57th and Sandy Boulevard about 11 last night.
A Fox 12 viewer sent us this video of the statue of the nation's third president as it was pulled down. While Thomas Jefferson wrote, "All men are created equal," he also owned as many as 600 slaves.
In historic Virginia churches, we told you yesterday, where George Washington frequently worshipped, will remove a memorial plaque honoring America's first president.
Where he spent 20 years of his life. The church will also take down a memorial honoring Robert E. Lee, but where does this political correctness stop?
So I'm sick of talking about this. I'm sick of having to fact check this claim that is undoubtedly and thoroughly debunked at this point. No doubt there's going to be more segments on CNN and the rest of the media throughout the day and the weekend that continue to make this claim, and I'll do my best to seek out all of them and expose them as the liars they are. You can help me in that mission by hitting that like button, sharing this video, and subscribing. Also, don't forget to hit that bell notification. If you want to further support this channel, you can do so by supporting the sponsors that keep us going or by making a donation on one of the platforms that are listed in the description or pinned comment. Thanks for watching. Keep coming back.